Hello students, welcome back to my channel MS Biology Tutorials. Today we are going to discuss about nodal anatomy. Before we start of this topic, please like, share and subscribe to my channel for more upcoming videos. So what is nodal anatomy? The stem of plants is differentiated into nodes and internodes. The anatomical features of the nodal region are quite different from that of the internodal region. This anatomical difference is due to the presence of vascular supply to the leaves and branches from the main vascular cylinder of the stem. Each leaf that originated from the nodes of higher plants possesses vascular tissues, and these vascular tissues of leaves are connected to that of stem. A vascular strand that extends between the vascular cylinder of stem and base of leaf is called leaf trace or foliar trace. The leaf trace possesses both xylem and phloem. The relative amount of xylem will be more in the leaf trace than phloem. Leaf trace helps to transport water and minerals from the xylem to the leaf lamina for photosynthesis. This figure showing that the leaf gaps and leaf trace are present in the main vascular cylinder. The circulation of photosynthetic products from the leaf lamina to the phloem of stem is also facilitated by the phloem strands in the leaf traces. In the vascular cylinder, just above the point of the departure of leaf trace, a small parenchymatous patch occurs. This parenchymatous region between the main vascular cylinder and leaf trace is called leaf gap or lacuna. Leaf gap is situated on the upper side of leaf trace. Nodes are classified on the basis of number of leaf gaps and leaf traces. So there are the three main types of nodes. First one is unilacular, second one is the trilacunar, and third one is the multilacunar. So we are discussing details. First, unilacunar nodes. A unilacunar node possesses only a single leaf gap to a leaf. Each leaf may possess one or two or three leaf traces. For example, Nerium and Lantana camara. So this figure showing that only one leaf gap are present in the main vascular cylinder. So that's why it's called the unilacunar node. Then trilacunar node. A trilacunar node possesses three leaf gaps and three leaf traces. Among these three leaf traces, the middle one will be larger and the other two lateral will be smaller. For example, Azadirachta directa indica. This figure showing that three leaf gaps are present and three leaf traces are present, and middle one is the larger as compared to other two. So that's why it's called the trilacunar node. Then last one, multilacunar node. This node possesses many leaf gaps and many leaf traces. Among the many leaf traces, the middle one will be larger and all other will be smaller. For example, Polygonum labium. And this figure showing that many leaf gaps are present and many leaf traces are present, and middle one is the larger and other one is smaller. So that's why it's called the multilacunar node. So these are the concept of nodal anatomy. Thank you.